So here's an unpopular opinion. I think a Generation X and maybe some elder millennials are probably the last generation that just will go out and just do stuff, even if they don't know how to do it. You know, if it's like some sort of task involved, they'll just sit there and figure it out and do it. What do you think? So in this particular case, this little driveway scraper thing, this black thing down here, it was designed to smooth out gravel in a driveway. Well, it needed a little bit of weight, so rather than go out and overthink it and buy something, just use a log and a trailer strap or a little, just a ratchet strap. Strap it down, get it tight, and hope for the best. Is it going to work? Sure. Is it going to work pretty nicely? Who knows, man? May have to be sort of scooted over a little bit. But the thing is that, you know, you didn't call nobody, you didn't ask for help, just sort of did it. And I think that's the way a lot of my generation, Generation X, kind of is. We just kind of do stuff ourselves and figure it out. And then over time, we learn from our mistakes, and hopefully we're passing that information along. You know, there's a whole generation of people out there that need some common sense knowledge and just general knowledge. You know, there's a trade-off. There's a lot of Generation X that's not too electronically minded. But you do have a group of Generation X that's just sort of a hybrid, right? All about the electronic stuff and manually doing stuff and DIY and how-to and all that junk. So, I don't know. And I'm sure a bunch of that's just from upbringing, right? Like my dad, he always attempted to do everything himself. And then if it didn't work out or whatever, then he would, you know, figure it out, get some help or whatever it took, right? Borrow off friends' knowledge. And there's always somebody that knows something, right? I don't know. It's just sort of one of those things, you know? If you can find a person who knows a lot, crusty as they may be, you might want to latch on to them if you want to learn some stuff. I don't know if that information or knowledge or even that style of learning things is being passed on. Yeah. I think you should always try to attempt it yourself. And then if it doesn't work out, figure it out. But at the same time, I think with age comes the ability to know when you can do it yourself or make a good attempt or not. You know, there's certain things I've learned over time that I just won't do anymore, right? I'll give you an example. One of them is working on your car at 9:30 at night, thinking a task that you were going to do is only going to take 10 minutes, knowing that you have to be up and out the door and going to work at like 5 o'clock in the morning, because it never works out. So, yeah. And also not being in a rush just to go and do tasks that you may have assigned yourself. You know, if you know it can wait till the weekend, then let it wait till the weekend. You don't need to go out there and run around and do it and then put yourself in a crisis situation trying to fix it or make the problem that you've caused better. You know, you just sort of learn, you know, you're like, I can do that now and run the risk of missing work or whatever, or I can just kind of let it wait until the weekend where I have more options. So I think that's part of the wisdom that happens when you get a little older. But it sure does take a long time to learn it. Especially if you're one of those hands-on type of people, like, I'm going to do this myself. I can do this. Of course I can. And I think that's why you see some people, some older people that are just be working with other people, right? Like a group of just, you know, mixed age people doing a task. And you've always got that older sort of fella or older person who's just calm, cool, and collected, not running around like freaked out with their chicken with their head cut off kind of a thing. Because I know what's up. So, they've survived a lot. But I don't think the older generation, like Gen X generation, and even, you know, late boomer generation, gets enough credit. You know, I think there's just a lot of pushback and a lot of idea out there that they just don't know what they're talking about or whatever. Or they're just trying to tell you what to do. And it's like, well, they have a lifetime of experience and they're trying to save you some inconvenience. Because tell you a little secret. Nobody wants inconvenience, especially when you get older, because inconvenience wrecks everything. But if you get everything sort of set up and you're doing whatever it is that you're doing and you can do it right, it's not inconvenience, right? Crisis doesn't have to be born from inconvenience, or the way around, I should say. Crisis shouldn't cause inconvenience. There should be a way to fix things. I don't really know what I'm trying to say. I'm trying to say that, you know, when you get older, you don't really care about the situation or whatever it is. It's the inconvenience behind it. And like, for example, let's say a flat tire or something like that. If you know that your tire is low on air, but you don't put air in it, and then it goes flat, or you have a rupture or a blowout on the highway, and now you have to call a tow truck, that, you know, that, or your parents, right, or something, that's inconvenience. You know, because you didn't take the time just to put a little bit of air in your tire, now you're stuck on the side of the road for probably a couple hours and possibly a dangerous situation where you have to call somebody for help. You know, that's the inconvenience part. You know, is everything that happens after whatever the problem is. It's not the problem itself. It's the in sort of inconvenience that occurs afterwards. And if that's basically brought about from a small amount of preparation that you decided not to do, you know, there you go. That's what they call biting in the ass, right? We're all guilty of it. It's just when you get older, you learn. Yeah, so sometimes it's better to take the extra minute or two and do something than to put it off for later. You know, I don't know. What is that called? Procrastination. So I'm just kind of rambling here because it's a real nice day. Check it out, man. It's nice out there compared to what we had in Western North Carolina just a couple, 3 weeks ago where the weather was really terrible. Just trying to appreciating the day, I guess. I need to do that more often. You do too, probably. So, yeah. Anyway, there you go. See ya.